Hi everyone, this is Dr. Surakshit, pediatrician. If you have been watching this video for the first time, or if you have been to this channel for the first time, I have been doing videos pertaining to child health. So if it's the first time, or if you are not subscribed to my channel, subscribe. So here we go for the today's topic, that is, can we give cow's milk in less than 1 year children? So let us discuss. Now, as soon as this child is born, most all the pediatricians say exclusively breastfeed the child for 6 months. Why is it so? Why is it important? So first let us see the difference between human milk or the breast milk and cow's milk. So in this chart we can see the protein content in cow's milk is very high. It's almost 3 grams and 1.1 gram in breast milk. And we can see the essential fatty acids, which is 13% in breast milk, whereas it's almost 2% in cow's milk. And the calcium phosphorus ratio, which is 2:1 in breast milk, but it's quite the opposite in cow's milk. And even sodium potassium, the solute, which is higher in cow's milk and low in breast milk. And the iron content is marginally low in cow's milk. So why this difference matters? Come, let's see. The first, protein. So as I have told, cow's milk has high protein. The cow's milk is made for the calf. The calf, as soon as it is born, so it stands, it walks very earlier, and even the body surface area is more. So the high protein content is made for the calf. But the human milk has 1.1 gram of protein, which is sufficient for the baby. And even the quality, so the human milk contains whey protein, which is very easily digestible, whereas the cow's milk contains casein, which is not easily digested by humans. So next, coming to the fatty acids, as I told. So essential fatty acids is 13% in human milk. So this helps in the brain growth and various development of the immunological system of the baby. So it's very important. So next, coming to the calcium and phosphorus. So the ratio of 2:1 is very favorable for absorption of this calcium. So in the breast milk, this ratio is present. So the calcium, whatever is found in the breast milk, gets absorbed very easily. So next, coming to the solutes or sodium and potassium, which is very high in cow's milk. As we can see, as soon as the baby is born, the kidneys are not yet matured. So very high solute load, if you give the kidneys, so it is, finds it difficult to filter all this. So we can see times children presenting with dehydration. With the children who are fed with the cow's milk, they come with dehydration, because the water also used for the filtration, that might cause dehydration also. And next, coming to the iron content. Iron content is marginally low in cow's milk, and whatever the iron which is found in breast milk is very easily absorbed. That is because of the other factors which are there, like lactoferrin, vitamin C, which is found in the breast milk, which helps in the absorption of iron. So these are the important factors and important differences between breast milk and cow's milk. And feeding cow's milk will cause the problems because of this, almost all the differences. So now let us see what is the guidelines of American Academy of Pediatrics, which says, you can see here, less than 1 year, we should not be feeding cow's milk. But at times we say, like, we start complementary feeds after 6 months. So when we start complementary feeds, to prepare these complementary feeds, like some porridges regarding like ragi or cereal based or some, so we put milk. So that will be in very minimal amount. So this minimal amount doesn't cause harm to the child. So other than that, we should not be giving milk or cow's milk in less than 1 year child. So next, what happens or if you feed the child with cow's milk? So let us see. As I have told you, first it causes anemia. Why is this anemia? As I told, the iron content is marginally low in cow's milk, and even the high calcium and phosphorus in the cow's milk, that hinders the absorption of the iron, whatever is present in it. And also, when we feed cow's milk, at times they can cause occult blood loss. That means the intestinal blood loss can be there. So even that is also a cause for anemia in these children. So next, we can see there is high saturated fatty acids in cow's milk. So that is prone for risk like hypercholesterolemia or cardiovascular risk as the child grows. And even the behavioral changes can be seen in children who are fed with cow's milk because of this anemia or certain brain development factors which might cause behavioral problems in children fed with cow's milk. And also, as I have told, sodium content is very high in cow's milk, so these children can be prone for hypertension in later life. So these are the various changes which we can see, or various risk factors if you feed the child with cow's milk. So what next after 1 year? How we are supposed to give the milk? So see, first, after 1 year, as you can see here the guidelines, that is also from American Academy of Pediatrics, we should give whole milk. The whole milk means which is rich in fat. Why is it important? This is important because it helps in the, again, the development and the brain development, and the major changes development takes place from 1 to 2 years. So we should be giving the child enough fat. So it should be a fat rich milk, not the toned milk which you should be giving. So there is also exception for this, which as we can see here, if the child is obese, if the child has hypercholesterolemia, or if there is the family risk of obesity, cardiovascular diseases or hypercholesterolemia, then we should give low fat milk. So this is the guidelines. So how much amount are we supposed to give? So the milk amount is like 250 ml we can give with breast milk. So as we are told, we should continue breastfeeding till 2 years. Okay, so after 2 years, what we are supposed to do? After 2 years, we can give low fat milk or reduced fat milk. So that you can give in an amount of almost 450 ml. So that will suffice. So there will be parents who ask questions like, my child doesn't drink enough milk, what should I do? So if the child doesn't drink milk, we can give all the products of milk like cheese, butter, or you can give like paneer. So all these products which are prepared out of milk is also as sufficient as drinking milk. So this will also do. Or what we are supposed to do, even this is not possible, so what next? So you can also give like what, milk supplies, calcium, protein. So whatever the food substances which has very rich calcium, very rich protein, we can give that. This is found in almost like sprouted
grains.
So sprouted dal or our ragi, our green leafy vegetables like palak, even non-vegetarians can take meat, fish, egg. So all this has enough proteins and calcium. So this will be sufficient if you feed the child with this. So there will be also questions, can we give added flavors like to the milk? Because the child doesn't drink only milk, can we give added flavors? So this added flavors at times contains high sugar. As you can see, again, the recommendation from American Academy of Pediatrics says that, so more than 2 years, we can give up to or even less than 25 grams of sugar. So if you give more sugar, so that might again cause like higher risk like cardiovascular diseases as the child grows. So this added sugar should be avoided. So even then there will be questions from parents asking, can we give energy drinks like the Boost, Complan or Pediasure, and so many in markets we can see, can we give that? So this is also the same, as we can see, these are some of the ingredients as I put here. So even this contains added sugar. So most of us, how we prepare it? We take 2 to 3 spoons of that like energy drinks, and then we even add sugar to that. So that causes more sugar. Like again, it gives more of added sugars to the children, which is not necessary. Unless like you can give homemade food which contains all the nutrients like fats, vitamins, minerals, carbohydrates, it's more than sufficient. It is not that by giving an energy drink is a must for your child. So the next question which comes is, okay, cow's milk you said it is we should not be giving. So can we give other like other substances like goat's milk or formula feeds, or even some people give donkey's milk? So is it better than cow's milk? So I can say nothing is better than breast milk as such, but if you cannot give breast milk, so then formula feeds should be given, not cow's milk. Okay, then less than 1 year, which I have been telling. So then you can see certain parents telling the child drinks only milk, nothing else. Is it good? So this is also not good, as because the milk doesn't give all the nutrients required for the growth and development. So whatever the amount which I have told, that much of milk will be sufficient. With that, we should give other nutrients which is found in the other food substances. Just giving milk doesn't fulfill all the calorie requirement or all the nutrients requirement. So this is also not good. So what happens is we drink only milk, sometimes the stomach gets full by only this liquid. What there will be, the child not doesn't take solid items. So this should be avoided as far as possible. Okay. Then at times people ask other questions, like now there is an new concept of organic milk. What is it, organic milk? How does it differ? So the organic milk means it should not have any hormones, like from the cow or cow which we get the milk, and it should not contain any antibiotics. So is it helpful? So the organ, there is a lot of debate regarding to this organic milk. So the FDA says that whatever the bovine growth factors are there, so it is not harmful. But American Academy of Pediatrics says there is still more research that should be going on into it. So still there is no clear guidelines onto what should be given or what should not be given. So still it has not come. So any other questions or any other queries you can have, you can leave a note in the comment section. And if you are not subscribed yet, subscribe to my channel. Thank you.